Hi, I'm Saurabh Basai, course instructor for fluid mechanics. In this presentation, we will learn about fluid kinematics and methods to describe fluid motion. Kinematics deals with the study of motion, whereas fluid kinematics deals with motion of fluids. So, it is study of how fluid flows and how to describe fluid motion. In fluid kinematics, the forces and movements which cause the motion of the fluid are not considered. Instead, only the flow will be visualized. Now we will learn about methods to describe fluid motion. In a fluid motion, each fluid particle has its own velocity and acceleration at any point and at time t. So the velocity and acceleration of a fluid particle may change both with respect to space and also time. Hence, while studying fluid flow, it is necessary to observe the motion of the fluid particles at various points in space, that is x, y and z direction, and at successive instants of time. There are two methods by which fluid motion can be described. First one is Lagrangian method and second is Eulerian method. In Lagrangian method, the path of the individual particle or object is followed. And in case of Eulerian method, the field variables are followed within the control volume. And these field variables are functions of space and time. First, we will find out what is Lagrangian approach. Here in this figure, three particles are considered, that is A, B and C. In this approach, any individual particle is selected. For example, if we select particle A, its behavior during its course of motion is observed, like for example, how the velocity, acceleration, pressure and temperature would change with change in time is noted. Position vector of each particle, that is xA, xB and xC, and also the velocity vector of each particle, that is vA, vB and VC, as functions of time will be noted. That means what will be the position of particle A at location 1 and what will be its position at 2 will be noted. Similarly, the velocity of particle at location 1 and what will be its velocity at location 2 will be noted, and that too with the variation of time. And this is a control mass approach. The example for Lagrangian approach is to track the location of a migrating bird. That means at time t equal to 10 minutes, its location is observed, and what will be its location at time t equal to 40 minutes is noted down. In Eulerian approach, any point in space occupied by the fluid is selected and observation is made at this particular point. And at this point, the observer will check out the change in field variables. Those are velocity, acceleration, pressure, temperature, etc. And this approach describes the flow field, which will be the function of position and time. And this is a control volume approach. The example for this approach is to count the number of birds passing a particular location. And also the study of water flowing in a pipeline is done by Eulerian approach. Here basically we are not bothered about the individual particle, but we are concerned about the variation in flow parameters like pressure, velocity, etc. In Eulerian description of fluid flow, a finite volume called flow domain or control volume is defined through which fluid will flow in and out. Instead of tracking individual fluid particles, fluid variables, which are field variables, are defined as functions of space and time within this control volume. In Eulerian approach, we don't care about what happens to the individual fluid particles, but are concerned with the field variables like, for example, pressure, velocity, acceleration, etc. of whichever fluid particles happens to be at this location and that particular instant of time. Field variables basically define the fluids. Here we can see three types of field variables. First one is pressure field, second is velocity field, and third one is acceleration field. Pressure field is a scalar field variable as it has got only magnitude and it is function of space, that is x, y, z, and time t. Whereas velocity field and acceleration field both are dependent on space, that is x, y, z, and time t. Both of these have got magnitude and direction. Velocity field implies a distribution of velocity in a given region, like for example here region R is considered. It is denoted in a functional form as v of x, y, z and t. That means velocity is a function of space, that is x, y, z, and time t. Velocity is a vector quantity as it has got both magnitude and direction. So we write v as function of space and time. Velocity may have three components, one in each direction. So here we can see three directions, that is x, y, and z. U represents velocity along x direction, v represents velocity along y direction, and w represents velocity along z direction. So resultant velocity v is ui plus vj plus wk, where u, v, and w are functions of space coordinates, x, y, z, and time t. This velocity field can be expanded in Cartesian coordinates as written below. V represents the resultant velocity, and the first component is the velocity along x direction, second is velocity along y direction, and third one represents velocity along z direction. Thank you.